Yo, hey guys, what's up? This is Yadhuvir Singh, and today I'm gonna tell you how to talk to a girl when you're calling them, because guys suck at it. Guys suck at everything. Most of my videos, you'll see that whatever I say is like, oh, I'm gonna tell you this thing, because most of the guys suck at it. So there are guys out there who don't know how to talk to women whenever they're calling them. They'll take the number, they're texting them, but the date is not coming. So what do you do? What to do on text and how to call a girl? But before that, there are some principles that you have to keep in mind whenever you're talking to women. So what are those principles? I'm just going to highlight that so that the next time you call a woman, it won't get, or she's like, what the fuck, why is he talking to me? I pick her phone up, pick his phone up. So how do you start calling a girl as soon as you have taken her number? The first principle is social value. Provide social value. What is it? Whenever I text a girl, I text with a meme. Why do I text with a meme? Because it offers value. So I'm keep on offering value. I'll text him and I'm like, how's it going? It was so amazing to meet you. And like, yeah, same here. And then I'll ask something like, so how's it going right now? What are you doing right now? It's like, nothing, I'm doing this right now, I'm doing that right now. As soon as I saw that she has read the message on the WhatsApp, there are two blue ticks, I'm gonna call her. Why I'm gonna call her at that time? Because the phone is in her hands. And I know the interaction was so amazing. And she was just feeling, oh man, this guy should call me, this guy should text me. Most of the times, whenever you number close a girl, she's thinking, she's giving you the number out of pity. She's giving you number, oh yeah, he won't leave me otherwise, yeah, so I'm just going to give him the number. No, whenever you number close, just remember this. So whenever you number close, she should be thinking, oh man, that this guy should call me. Oh fuck, this guy should text me as soon as possible. I want to meet him again. And this should be the frame whenever you number close. But what is happening most of the times whenever you number close, you're like, oh man, she should text me back. Oh man, is she going to text me back? Oh man, are we going to meet each other again? So you see the difference in frames. How I close a girl and how you close a girl. You close a girl by saying something like, oh man, I'm gonna text her again. Is she going to reply back? And when I close a girl, she's thinking, oh man, is he going to text me? So you see the value difference. So whenever I text, I offer values and she's like, oh hi, la la la. And then I'll say something like, amazing to meet you, nice to meet you. As you can see in this message, like what I'm saying is like, boom, nice to meet you, blah blah blah. When can we meet again? This. So you see, I just give, you know, good compliments, like it was amazing talking to you. So it's like offering value. No one wants to be with a person who's like fucking sucked up in his life, who's like a value leech. So when you are going to leech, it's not a leeching, it's like getting something back. Okay, so you want sex, I know that, but how to go towards it so that she's like, oh fuck, this guy is so fucking leechy, I don't even want him. So number one, offer value whenever you're texting her. As soon as she texts back, ask her like, what is she doing right now and all that. She's going to text back, she's doing this right now. As soon as you see, you send some message and there are blue ticks, call her as soon as possible. Or as soon as she replies back, call her as soon as possible, because the phone is in her hands. See, whenever you are doing text gaming, it's pretty easy for women to say no on a text. But what we study in pickup is the whole interaction is 7% verbal and 93% non-verbal. 7% verbal. What does it mean? If I want her to come and meet me, rather than just texting her where she's having full freedom to say a no, I'll call her, because the interaction is 7% verbal. So whenever I'm going to talk to her, there is a probability that she's going to say yes, because the interaction is going to make an impact. So whenever I'm going to call her, I'm going to be like, there's some points that I'm going to just focus upon whenever I'm going to call her. The first point is, the call has to be short, because I'm a busy guy. This thing. So most of the guys, whenever they're going to talk to women, they're like, they're going to talk for like, I don't know how much hours and hours and hours, 45 minutes, 1 hour and all that. It just shows women that you are so fucking, you don't have a purpose in life. You're out of purpose. There's no purpose in life and you have nothing to do. So yeah, you're just calling her and talking to her and this and that. So it totally turns off the women when they come to know that this guy is out of purpose in his life. The second thing is, whenever you're calling them, like, spike emotions as much as possible. So how do I call? Listen to this call right now.
Yo, what's up? What's up?
Hey, good.
Huh? Fine, you reach? You're fine?
Hey, I'm fine. I'm not fine.
You're not just fine. You're missing me just now. I just left you. You started missing me already.
Are you missing me? You,
I'm missing you so much, so much.
Hey, huh? I know you're missing me.
We were in the bus, so I couldn't talk to you properly. Come to Phoenix.
Hey. Hey, are you home?
What?
Are you home?
Yeah, I'm home.
Okay, let me show.
Huh?
Let me go to the shower.
Yeah, yeah, go take a shower. What, you call me to get a shower with you?
No, I'm not sure, but I'm not sure.
Let's take a shower together. I'm just kidding. Okay. I am checking in the hotel right now, so I'll call you back. And come to Phoenix tonight.
Okay.
Fine?
Okay.
So then, see you, Vanessa.
Yes.
Chocolate.
So as you can see, what am I doing right now? I'm having fun while the call. I'm showing like, even if she's not there, I am having fun. Most of the guys, you know, they'll go out on day twos, they'll go out on dates, but the girls will flake. They won't even come. And the guys will be like, what the fuck is this? How can she flake on me? Do you know what do I do when I go out on day twos? I'll be like, I'll be at the location where I'm meeting the girl like 1 hour before. And there at the location, I'm going to approach so many other women. And whenever she's going to come, she's going to see me with the other women. And then there is pre-selection working for me. She's going to think like, oh man, this guy's already got friends over here. This and that. So all of this pre-selection things is working. And the most important fact is that even if she's not there, I'm not getting bored. I'm working. I'm like, yay, fun, pick up. So I don't really need her, okay? Whenever she senses that this guy, he doesn't need me, she's like, what the fuck is this guy? All the guys need me, but this guy don't need me. He wants me, but he don't need me. Why, what the fuck, why don't he need me? And this turns them on more and more. This changes the frame. Then they start chasing you because they want you to need them. And for that, they start chasing you so that, you know, somehow, somewhere you will slip. And she'll maintain the frame and then you'll start chasing them. But if you keep on holding the frame, she'll keep on chasing so that you started needing them. But the moment that need comes in inside you, the neediness is visible. And once you're needy, your frame is broken and she's like, ah, she's like total turn off. She'll turn off. She'll like, I don't want to be with this guy because he's not a reward anymore. So whatever is a reward, she wants that. She don't want a guy out of pity. So whenever she gives you number out of pity, like, yeah, just take my number and leave me, she won't come. Obviously, she won't. That's not even a number close. That's like out of pity close. Okay, she's like, ah, nice boy, nice talking to you, bye-bye, take my number and leave. But solid number close. Always focus on number closing solid in a solid way. So how do you do the solid number close? Whenever you're going to take the number, tell her that we are going to meet again. I don't know when I'm free, but I would love to meet you again. I loved your energy. I don't know whatever you loved in her because you were talking to her for so much time. So tell her what you like in her. Because most of the girls, you know, whenever they are giving number, they are thinking like, why should I give? Like this guy, yeah, he's talking to me. Yeah, he's a lover. Yeah, he's an alpha. But why should I give my number? Why should we meet again? She don't know that you like her. So you qualify her, you tell her that how much you like her, what do you like in her and all that, and then you go for the number. I'll say something like, I like you, I don't know why, you know, your energy is amazing, your vibe is amazing, so, and we, you know, there's so many similarities between us, so I would love to meet you again. What do you do on weekends? Like, ah, I do this on weekends, I do that on weekends, like, amazing, what's your number? So I'll qualify her and then I'll close her. This is called as a solid number close, where she's like, yeah, I'm free on this. So we can meet at that point. But when I'll go home, I won't text her. So she's waiting in her mind. She's like, when is this guy going to text me? And whenever you text her, it's like a blessing in disguise for her. She's like, what the fuck? This guy, the love of my life. He finally texted me. And then this is where the girls fall madly in love with you. When they are like, this guy is having fun even without me. That means even if I'm not there, his life is so fucking fun. And that's why they want to hang out with you more and more, because they want to be with the fun guy more and more. No one likes to be with a fucking ugly bitchy guy who's like very needy, but this guy is having fun with or without women. And he has got a lot of pictures on Instagram with other women. That means there are so many other women who trust him. So there are so many things that are going on with this guy. So what the fuck is this guy? So these all things, you know, this mystery and all those things, you know, this turns a woman on, which tells her that, okay, I have to go for this guy. This guy is something else. This guy is interesting. I would like to tame this fucking beast. I would like to tame this wild animal. So you become like something, you know, like this kind of guy, like grounded, unreactive alpha. Whenever you're like this, they are never going to reject you. Okay. There are some women who won't like you. Doesn't matter what you do, because not everyone in this world can like you, but 80% of women are just going to fall in love with you if you are unreactive, you're holding your frame, you're not needy. But the moment the chase frame changes, the moment you started needing them, you started showing them that there is something that you are having that I want, they're like, fuck you, bitch, leave me alone. That's what happens when you're walking on the road, someone selling encyclopedias approach, you're like, what the fuck, I don't want to give you my money, and you leave. Same way it happens to women. Okay, they see a guy wants to have sex with them, like, fuck you, bitch, there's so many guys want to do this, I'm just going to leave you forever. So this is the thing, whenever you're going to talk to them, don't be fucking needy. Neediness is the greatest turn off for women. So talking on the phone. So whenever you're going to call them, before that, as I've already told you, you have to send messages that builds up the social vibe. Okay, so it's like offering value kind of messages. And then she started replying as soon as she sees the message, you call her. And as the 7% of interaction is totally verbal, so there's higher possibility that she will say yes for a meet whenever you're going to call her. And you have to call her at the right moment when she sees the message, when you know the phone is in her hands, so that she'll have to pick up your phone. And then when she picks the phone, don't talk for more than 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, tell her that you are busy right now, like blah, 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 like I have to go right now, what you're doing, this and that, and have some fun. And tell her that, like, you're having so much of fun over here, blah, 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 blah. For example, most of the times, you know, I'm reading book, I'm like, you know what, it's so fucking amazing, I'm alone and I'm reading books, that's the most amazing experience in life. And she's like, what the fuck, this guy, he's having fun without me, how dare is he having fun without me, I want to have fun with him. And then she's like, when are we meeting, when are we coming back again, when are you meeting, this and that. And that's how the frame is always set. So, you know, the most of it, like how to get women to come on day twos whenever you're going to call them, it's more about like how much they want you to come, how much they want you to meet. Okay, it's always about both of you. It's never about just you. It's not just you who wants to meet her, she also wants to meet you. And for that, you need to always remember these principles whenever you're going to go on the call. Number one, text her first, offer her value, and as soon as she starts replying, the phone is in her hands, call her 5 to 10 minutes, talk to her, tell her that you're busy, tell her that you're having fun, tell her that you're with your friends, tell her that you're in a party. And then you ask her like, I don't know when I'm free, maybe I'm free this weekend, what are you doing this weekend? And then she's like, nothing, I have classes till Friday, on Friday night, and then Saturday, Sunday, I'm free. And then you can tell her, okay, so Saturday night, let's see, I don't know, I'll text you on Friday, but let's see if we can catch up on Saturday. Right now I'm in a party, so I'm gonna call you back on Friday. Till then, hasta la vista. And she's like, hey, 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 nice to meet you. And I'm like, ah, amazing to meet you, bye bye. And then you cut the call, and that's how you set the fucking date. And then you call her back on Friday. No need of texting her now, okay? You call her back on Friday and like, yo, what's up, blah, 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 blah. And then you're like, fun again. And she's like, what the fuck, this guy is always having fun. He's like never out of energy. Whenever he calls me, he's always fucking having fun. So she wants to have fun too. And she's like, what are you doing right now? And then you're like, nothing, I'm not doing anything right now, I'm talking to you. And it's like, no, there is music, you know, the sound of music behind you, there are people, so many people. And then you're like, yeah, 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 I'm out with my friends, I'm having fun. And like, what the fuck, you're always having fun, I'm not having fun, I'm the boring creature in the world, isn't that? Like, nothing, we are meeting tomorrow, it's going to be so fucking amazing, we're going to do this, do that. So she's already fallen for you, okay? So if she's already fallen for you, it gets very easy for you to pull and all that game her, okay? So these are the things that you have to focus upon whenever you're going to call a girl. So if this video has helped you, give me a thumbs up, comment, and until next time, motherfucker, bye.